Good morning, cadets. We have been discussing about three kinds of waves: mechanical waves, electromagnetic waves, and the matter waves. So in this class, we are focusing only on mechanical waves. The mechanical waves are the waves which require material medium for their propagation. Propagation means for their traveling. So we are discussing only about mechanical waves. As I told you, electromagnetic waves and matter waves, part of them we are learning in 12th class in detail. So what are the features of mechanical waves? The waves which are produced on a medium, we discussed the examples of water ripples, the vibrations of the stretched membrane of tabla, vibrations of stretched membranes of the drum, musical instruments, the vibrations of air in a flute, or vibrations of air in a shahnai in case of wind instruments, vibrations of string in case of string instruments. So you can quote number of examples. The sound wave which you are listening, the sound waves also require material medium for their propagation. As I told you, medium may be solid, liquid, or gas. Okay, so out of these mechanical waves, there are basically two types of waves: transverse waves and longitudinal waves. Whether it is a transverse wave or a longitudinal wave, there are basically two things required for the medium to have. The medium should have elastic property, the medium should have inertial property. Elastic property, you know, the particles, when they are disturbed, they should be able to come back to their initial position. That's what we call it as elasticity. They should not be able to change their shape permanently. So they should be possessing restoring force. A medium should be possessing restoring force. When a strong restoring force acts due to elasticity, then only the vibrations can be set up. The pattern of vibrations carrying the energy from one point to another point on the medium surface constitutes wave propagation, as we have discussed. So for the vibrations to be set up, the particles, once they are set up in vibrations, once they are set up in oscillations, they should be restored back, they should be brought back to their initial positions. In order to do so, there should be a restoring force acting on them. So that is what we call it as elastic property. For example, if you take a string or a rope or a thread, or even, for example, rubber band, unless it is stretched, the rubber band cannot vibrate. It's our common experience. Unless a rope being stretched, one end of the rope should be connected to a rigid support, other end of the rope should be stretched, then only you can give jerks and produce wave patterns, up and down wave patterns. So stretch is required. In a string instrument, you know, like guitar, veena, you can take any string instrument. Before it is set for playing, the strings are tightened with the help of screws. The strings are tightened so that there will be tension in the string. When there is a tension in the string, then only it can vibrate and it can produce sound. So elastic property is very essential. Then inertial property. Mass is the measure of inertia. There should be some amount of mass. So how are these two things? One is elasticity, another one is inertia, play important role. You will understand clearly as we move on, as we go on discussing about the features of these waves. Okay, first let us learn about the transverse waves. Water ripples are the examples of transverse waves. The vibrations of a string, when the stretched string is set for vibrations, up and down vibrations of the string, are the examples of transverse waves. Right? What is a transverse wave? A wave in which the particles of the medium oscillate up and down, or particles of the medium oscillate or vibrate up and down perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave is called as transverse wave.
A wave in which particles of the medium oscillate up and down. Up and down means perpendicular. The direction of propagation is called a transverse wave. Suppose this is a stretched rope. One end of the rope is fixed to a rigid support. Symbolically, we represent rigid support in this manner. And then, if we just give a jerk, just up and down jerk above the stretched rope, one end of the rope should be connected to the rigid support. Other end should be held stretched. So this is stretched rope. Stretched rope. When we give an up and down jerk, then what happens? You will find a pulse being produced at this moment. And this pulse you will find being traveling from this end to this other end. After a certain time, this pulse will be seen this side. After a certain time, it will be seen here. After some time, it will be seen here. It will be seen here. And it will be able to reach the other end of the stretched rope or stretched string. If the length of this stretched string is quite longer, then the pulse may not reach the other end. It may damp out before reaching the other end. So if it is a medium size or a short stretched rope or a stretched string, then you can see the pulse. Pulse means what? It is a pattern of single disturbance. Pattern of single disturbance. Is called as pulse. You know this pattern we call it as wave. So we can also say that wave of single disturbance. Is called pulse. When I just clap, this is pulse. If I keep on clapping one after the other, the continuous disturbances cause the wave. A wave of single disturbance is called as pulse. I think you got it. So I have produced pulse of sound. If I am producing continuously the disturbances, then it is a continuous wave. Right? So here I have given a single jerk. That single jerk has caused the particles of the rope to move up and come back to the same position. So this energy is being transferred to the next neighbor lying particle.
that particle also goes up and come down. So that energy is next being carried by the next nearby lying particle. In this way, the particles, after getting the energy, they just move up and come down. They move up and come down. So when they move up, restoring force must be acting on them so that they come down and form a pattern of vibration, which we call as wave. So a pattern of single disturbance or a wave of single disturbance is called as pulse. If you produce up and down jerk, if for example, if I am taking the rope up, down and again down and up, one full up and down and up for one complete cycle if I take it, then you will find a wave of this nature is being produced, and this is found to travel. This is found to travel from this end to the other end. So first it will be at this position, next moment it will be here, next moment the energy will be transferred to the next neighboring line particles, and the particles move up and down, and thus the wave propagates along the length of the stretch string. Even after reaching here, if it is having sufficient energy, the wave may get reflected back. We will be able to see reflected wave. So this is what we call as propagation of wave, traveling of wave. Traveling of wave is called propagation. Propagation of wave. So, in case of a transverse wave, as I have been saying here, you will find the particles of the medium vibrating or oscillating up and down. As a result, you will find alternating crest and troughs. Crest and troughs. Crest and troughs are being formed. This is called crest and this is called trough. Crest, trough. What is a crest? Crest is the maximum displacement of the particle from the undisturbed position. Maximum disturbance of the particle or maximum displacement of the particle from the undisturbed position is definitely giving us amplitude. So when it is oscillating up and down, we call it as crest. When it goes down, it is maximum depression. Maximum depression, that is also maximum displacement in the downward direction. So that causes trough. T-R-O-U-G-H. Trough. Crest and troughs are being formed alternatively. So things to be noted down here is that particles of the medium oscillate perpendicular to the direction of propagation. If this is the direction of propagation, the particles are moving up and down, or they may do oscillations even in the horizontal plane also. Now I have drawn in the plane of the board, even the particles can move in the perpendicular direction, perpendicular to the plane of the board. There also, if you observe, if this is the direction of propagation, the oscillations of the particles are perpendicular to the direction of propagation. Such a wave constitutes transverse wave. Examples: water ripples, vibrations on the string, or stretched rope. Vibrations on the stretched rope. So
should move back to their initial position. So they should possess the property of elasticity. So medium should be elasticity, or medium should be possessing property of elasticity, or medium should be elastic. So basically, restoring force must be acting on the particles. So when we speak of elasticity, a stretched string or a stretched membrane or a stretched rope will have a tension. As a result, when you set a particle into vibration, the particles which are lying in adjunct with in the lying in neighboring grid of the particles will tend to have sharing stress. So they will possess property of sharing stress, tangential force per unit area. So once they possess the shearing stress, then they will have a kind of movement, the pattern of moving up and down. They tend to change their shape tangentially. So again, they should be able to retain their shape back. That's how we speak in terms of shearing stress. So the restoring force for unit area must be shearing stress. So the medium should possess shear stress. So generally, solids, the waves which are produced on the surface of the solids, are generally due to shearing stress, and thus they are generally transverse waves. Whereas in case of fluids, fluids means the liquids and gases, there will be compressibility. So compressive stress will be observed. So the elastic property of compressibility or compressive stress is being exhibited in the case of the fluids like liquids and gases. Therefore, in the case of liquids and gases, we will find another type of waves called as longitudinal waves. In longitudinal waves, what happens? The particles of the medium, they vibrate. They vibrate parallel to the direction of propagation. When the particles of the medium vibrate parallel to the direction of propagation, they constitute what is known as a longitudinal wave. So sound is a longitudinal wave. When I speak, the particles of the air, they move back and forth along the direction of propagation. When they move back and forth, there is a region of high compressibility. The air particles are being compressed at one particular region where the density increases and pressure increases. Again, the particles return back. When the particles return back, they form what is known as rarefaction. When the particles are pushed, they form a region of high density called as compression. So this compression is carried from one point to another point, until the wave reaches the destination, the wave reaches the detector. So it appears as if the compressions are being carried from point of disturbance to the point of detector. One after the other, the compressions are being carried, or in other words, you can also say in between two compressions you will find rarefactions. So rarefactions are also being observed alternatively. So the example for longitudinal wave is a sound wave. The waves which are generally produced in liquids and gases are usually longitudinal waves. I am speaking inside the volume of liquid or gas, the waves that are produced are longitudinal in nature. So what are the properties of longitudinal wave? Now we will define what is a longitudinal wave. A wave in which the particles of the medium particles of the medium vibrate parallel. Look at this. Here is perpendicular, here it is vibrate parallel to the direction of propagation. Such a wave is called longitudinal wave. Example, sound waves. Sound waves which are produced in the air, sound waves which are produced in the water. Right? So, sound waves are longitudinal waves. So, what is happening in the sound waves? So, suppose it is a continuous medium, particles of the medium, particles of the medium. Suppose there is a source here which is producing sound. Then, immediately, when there is a source here, which is producing sound, like you can give example of a speaker. When it produces sound, what happens? The air molecules which are there immediately, they are pushed at one particular place immediately. So here you will find a region of high density. And these air particles again move back and they form here a region of low density. This energy is then again carried by the next neighborly lying particles, and these particles are also pushed apart, and when they are pushed apart they form a region of high density, and in between again the particles are returning back. When they are returning back, the distance between the particles increases and that becomes a region of low density and low pressure. So that is how it causes rarefactions. So alternatively you find formation of compressions and rarefactions. Compressions and rarefactions. So here, this is the direction of propagation of sound, sound wave, wave propagation, and here the particles are moving back and forth along the direction of propagation, they move back and forth. So such a wave in which the particles of the medium oscillate back and forth about the direction of propagation, parallel to the direction of propagation, they constitute what is known as longitudinal wave. So we will find region of high density and high pressure called as compressions. High density and high pressure. Here you can see the particles are very closely lying, where the density of particles increases and that region pressure increases. Here the region where the particles are returning back, the density of the particles decreases and it causes a region of low pressure, and this region of low pressure is called as rarefaction. So alternatively we will find rarefaction in between the compressions. So you will find compressions and rarefactions being formed as a result of a longitudinal wave traveling in a medium like air or liquid. So generally in fluids, fluids like air or mixture of gases, and liquids. longitudinal waves are observed.
So what is the compression? Compression is the region of high density and high pressure. Rarefaction is the region of low density and low pressure. So alternatively, you will find in the region where the sound is propagating, you will find the regions of high pressure, low pressure, high pressure, low pressure, high pressure, low pressure. It appears as if the high pressure compressions are moving from one end to another end as long as the sound is being produced and sound is being found traveling. When there is a progressive sound wave, or when there is a sound wave propagation in a particular direction, you will find as if the compressions are being produced alternatively and as if the compressions are moving from one point to another point. So such a wave is called as progressive wave or traveling sound wave or traveling longitudinal wave. So in a case of a longitudinal wave, we will find alternative formation of compressions and rarefactions. Compressions and rarefactions are being formed alternatively. Compressions and rarefactions. Compression is a region of high pressure and high density. Density is denoted by rho. And what is rarefaction? Rarefaction is the region of low pressure and low density. So which elastic property is responsible for this compressibility? So you can say that it is basically the compressibility of the fluids, little bit of compressibility of the fluids, which leads to this kind of longitudinal wave propagation. The elastic property corresponding to compressibility is called as, what is it called? Hydraulic stress or pressure. Hydraulic stress, right? Or volumetric stress. Volumetric stress should be the elastic property of such fluids, especially gases, which are responsible for the propagation of longitudinal waves. Okay. Very important thing is to be noted here. Transverse wave can travel through only those media which can sustain the shearing stress, such as solids. Solids can only sustain the shearing stress, not the fluids. Therefore, transverse waves can travel through only those media which can sustain shearing stress, such as solids, not the fluids. Whereas, fluids as well as solids can sustain compressive stress and compressive strain, as we have studied earlier. Hence, longitudinal waves can be propagated in all elastic media. Longitudinal waves can be propagated in all elastic media. For example, steel. The vibrations of the steel on the surface will be found to be transverse. The particles on the surface of the steel will be moving up and down, and thus they produce the transverse waves. Whereas if you look into the depth of the steel, suppose it is a steel rod, right? And if the steel rod is being disturbed at one end, then on the surface of the steel rod, the particles of the steel will be vibrating up and down and they cause transverse. But inside that medium, inside the steel rod, if you go into the depth of the steel, then you will find the particles of the steel vibrating back and forth along the direction of propagation of the sound. So the steel will have both propagation of transverse as well as longitudinal waves. The solids can have both the solids can allow both transverse as well as longitudinal waves. So basically understand, when the particles are moving up and down, they produce what is known as transverse wave. When the particles are moving back and forth and vibrate along the direction of propagation, then they cause longitudinal waves. So in case of solids like steel, one can have both the transverse wave propagation as well as longitudinal wave propagation, right? Now one more example, the example of the waves produced inside the water. When there is a disturbance inside the water, you see on the surface of the water you will find the water ripples being formed. The water ripples of short wavelength, they are called as capillary waves. So water surface, these are the waves which are of very short wavelength. Distance between two successive crests will be very short, of the order of some millimeters to centimeters. They are called as capillary waves, just on the surface of the water. Second type is gravity waves. Gravity waves can be observed in the oceans. As a result of gravity waves, the water can be raised up to certain height and again the water will be falling down. And in this case of gravity waves, the gravitational pull of the earth acts as the restoring force. Gravitational pull of the earth will be acting on the rising of water due to very high energy. So gravity waves are caused due to the vibration of water molecules or vibration of water particles, which are of the order of very long wavelengths, of the order of few meters to about 100 meters. Tides, you can say, the tides which are caused, they are gravity waves. So the gravitational force or the gravity acts as a restoring force. So gravity waves will be having very long wavelengths, very long wavelengths of the order of few meters to about 100 meters. So the elastic property is due to the gravitational force that is acting as a restoring force. In this case, capillary waves, which are of short wavelength, water ripples. Short wavelength water ripples, which will be above the surface. And which one is the restoring force here? The restoring force that is acting over here is the surface tension. Surface tension of the water surface acts as the restoring force. So in case of a disturbed water in the oceans, it's very difficult, it's complicated to find out whether the wave is longitudinal or transverse. So we will find both longitudinal waves as well as transverse waves in the case of oceans. It's quite complicated. Okay. Now let us see some of the examples. We can just go go through certain examples and find out whether it is a transverse or longitudinal. Motion of a king in a long spring, stretched spring. If there is a stretched spring, it is called as sleepy. Motion of a king. King means if you just give one up and down jerk, then it will have disturbance of this nature. So this motion of a king will produce a transverse wave. If the kink is produced to and fro, if the kink is produced up and down, it will produce transverse disturbances or transverse wave pattern. If the kink is just given jerk back and forth, if the kink is pulled back and forth, it will produce longitudinal pattern, longitudinal wave. Continuous jerks, if they are produced, if we have to stretch this, you must have enjoyed with such slinky nowadays, they are available in the market. One end of the slinky must be connected to the rigid support, other end should be stretched. Just give small jerk. If it is two and four small jerk, it will cause compressions. Compressions are found to travel from this end to this end. So it will be able to produce longitudinal also. If the kink is produced up and down, then it will produce transverse waves. So both can be demonstrated using the slinky. Stretched long spring. A long spring is called as slinky. So both transverse as well as longitudinal waves can be demonstrated. Let us see second examples. Example, waves produced in a cylinder containing liquid by moving the piston back and forth. If there is a cylinder fitted with the piston, if the cylinder is being filled with some fluid, a liquid or a gas, if it is being filled with the fluid, if this piston is pushed in and pushed out, if the piston is pushed in and pushed out continuously, then you will find formation of compressions of high pressure and rarefactions of low pressure regions. And these compressions and rarefactions are found to move from one end to the other end, to the end of the bottom. And thus you will find formation of longitudinal waves, pattern of longitudinal waves in the fluids. Because the particles of the medium are oscillating back and forth along the direction of propagation. So you will find formation of compressions, rarefactions, compressions and rarefactions. It appears as if these compressions and rarefactions are traveling along the direction of propagation of a longitudinal wave. Third one, waves produced by a motor boat sailing on water surface. You must have observed when a motor boat moves on the water surface, on a pond water surface or a river water surface, you will find the turbulence of water behind the water boat. There you will find the water moving away in the form of a transverse wave. And just around the boat, you will find the water molecules being compressed and afterwards rising up. Compression and rarefaction will be seen. So you will find both transverse wave formation as well as a kind of longitudinal wave formation as being explained here. So the turbulence is being caused, and the turbulence will be having water ripples, having transverse pattern, and inside the water you will find longitudinal pattern. So you will find both longitudinal as well as the transverse wave pattern. Ultrasonic sound that is being produced in the air. The ultrasonic waves in air produced by a vibrating quartz crystal. The ultrasonic ultrasonic wave that is produced. Remember, ultrasonic is nothing but another kind of sound wave. So it is a longitudinal wave. So it will cause disturbance in the air. The disturbance in the air will be leaving the air particles to move back and forth along the direction of propagation, causing compressions and rarefactions. and thus it will cause a longitudinal wave. So remember, the elastic property, as far as longitudinal wave is concerned, the elastic property of longitudinal wave is compressive stress and compressive strain. That's what we call as volumetric, that is compressive stress divided by compressive strain, bulk modulus, right? Bulk modulus is important, compressibility. Whereas in the case of solids, for the transfer of transverse waves, it is shearing stress and shearing strain. Shearing stress and strain, shearing strain, if you remember, the ratio of shearing stress to the shearing strain gives us shear modulus, modulus of rigidity. So these elastic properties are very important for the traveling of transverse waves and longitudinal waves, right? So elastic properties are very important. That's how mechanical waves are being produced on the medium. So the mechanical waves require material medium. The material medium should have these properties of elasticity, especially shear modulus, or what you call it as modulus of rigidity as far as the solids are concerned, and compressibility, what is known as compressive stress by compressive strain, bulk modulus is the very important property of the fluids which will allow the longitudinal waves to travel. Okay, so in the next video session we will learn about the traveling of a wave, the displacement relation in the progressive waves. So when a wave travels, we call it as a progressive wave. The features of progressive wave we are going to learn in the next video. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.